Okay, it's April 27th, 2019. It's 6:10 p.m. I was going to do this 2 hours ago, but got sidetracked like everything else. I got beans all in here. Going to go up to the frame, my mom's frame, her swing. Going to tie strings, come down from those five or six little leads, I call them. And then I got bush beans going to be growing in here. One, two, three, four, five. And then on the east wall, I call it, or fence, I planted sunflowers. The traditional yellow, well, skinny sunflower with the big yellow head. And then the bushy torch sunflowers. You can see some of them down there. These here are torch sunflowers. They should be the big yellow, orange, bushy ones. The hummingbirds and the honeybees and the large-winged butterflies. A lot of stuff growing in here. I'm not going to be able to do it all too good, but I got them some started, you know, with different, sunflowers. See, nothing's growing all in here for some reason, don't know why. I just plant more. I've planted about three different plantings in here, so it's getting kind of hard to figure out where I planted and where I not want to plant. See, and then where there's some up here, like that big one there, that's a torch. Torch. And then that's it. I'm surprised. I thought I saw a couple other sunflowers over here, but right now I can't see them with my naked eye. Then I got space here when we mow. Come over here. This is the north wall. See, everything's facing the sun. The sun's setting in the west. You see the plants are tilted to the west. Those, I believe, are torch sunflowers right there. I'm gonna zoom in. If this doesn't shut off, it's a Sony camera, so that's why it shuts off. Right there. There in the middle. There, I don't know, this might be the yellow sunflowers in here too. There's should be yellow sunflowers and then the torch mixed together. See, a lot of this grass, it's real hard to get all this. Look at this right here as we get closer up here. So much grass in the middle. The sunflowers will come through still. As you can see that one right there. And then you see those right there. This is about 65 feet going from east to west on the north end. I'm video recording this. And then down here when you get to the northwest end, that's a torch sunflower. That's a torch sunflower. Not positive, maybe. These last three might be the yellow sunflower, but that's a torch sunflower. And over here I got okra planted, and then I put mulch, black mulch on top there. There's one coming up right here. That one just came up. See the leaf right there. And then that's two red and two green okra. There's one that I planted the seed down there, and then the seed right here. Just for reference, let me step back on the north end here. Ouch. Facing south. So I got okra with one, it's growing up through the mulch down there, and okra. Where there's a green coated tomato steak like this one here, it's kind of got like the metal around it. That's where peppers are going to go. We're going to have basil right there. Pepper with that green one right there, basil and that other short one. We've got spaghetti squash going right here. It wasn't looking too good, and then I put some proto-grow on there, and it's coming out looking a little bit better here. I got the mulch on there and poured some proto-grow in there. Now it's looking healthier. We planted two seeds in that one and two seeds in that one over there. So I got two zucchinis, four total, but two seeds in each place for them right in here. See, I have this curved. This is green zucchini, black beauty zucchini right down there. Gonna come up over in the garden with the beans. See, there's some torch sunflowers right there coming up. They were here from last year, so we just put mulch around them. It's tricky to mow around this, but you know, it'd be nice. I planted green peas in here, and there's one coming up right there. Yeah, let me zoom in a little bit. It's a green pea, sweet pea, whatever, English pea. I put two in there. I put two down here. Looks like two of them are growing down there too. The green, you can barely see it in the middle. And then right here, I planted two. And I planted the various, three different types of beans here. I put two in each hole. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Where's the other one? Right down there by the brick. And see, I got those little hat pieces of fence to use them to start to grow on. And then I have the string going up to the frame of the swing. This one will go to this other makeshift fence I did. And it can go on to the swing. So we'll have five beans going toward that frame. Jeez, I can't think what else I was going to say. Last year we had over 160 oak garlic planted, and we've got 140 good-sized bulbs. We didn't plant any more out here, but look at out here. Garlic. All this is garlic. Excuse me. See all the garlic? The winds have calmed down out here quite a bit, too. I mean, that's why you can see how those are moving around a little bit. It's got mild winds. It's a hummingbird feeder on the frame of the swing. We can't put peppers or tomatoes out here because the winds will just kill them. We have to wait till like the middle, around the end of May, actually. Maybe a little bit sooner, but it's going to be hard because all these thick tomatoes, things, these are from my mom's swing that I had cut in half. It's a 1 by 1 inch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9 sticks out here for tomatoes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 places for peppers out here. 1, 2, 3, 5. 6. 5 peppers and 9 tomato plants will be able to come out here. God bless it. Hold on. See, that's what happens when you don't light your cigar. Oh, look at the bird. I'm going to show you on here if I can get it on there before it flies away. Where's he at? Oh, he just flew off into that genetically modified wheat from Monsanto. That's about 25 feet north of my garden. And this is CJ's and Lucy's graves. Lucy's cross has got a short and a wire, so that won't light up tonight. This one will. But all of the spotlights will light up onto their graves tonight. See, there's sunflowers going all around the border here. That's the west border. Let's see if I can see the winds have actually moved this. Move it up a little bit. There we go. CJ right down there, and Lucy's right about down there, snuggled. And then out here I've got these elderberry trees, or bushes, I should say. Now, when they first came, there was two of them separate, and they looked just like bare branches, about 3 branches each. That's all it looked like. And now they're up to my shoulders, and they're branching, they're filling out, getting leaves all over them. This one right here, was like one that it was growing apart from that one over there. So we dug that up real good and we put it down here, and it's taking. So that'll be a third elderberry. This one here is up to my face right there. So here's your elderberries. So I'm going to the farthest west end of this yard. Well, not all the way, because see, that's all Monsanto right there on the edge.